I picked up a PlayStation 4 Pro, and I'm going to do a system transfer from my launched PlayStation 4 to the PlayStation 4 Pro. It's sitting on my 360 because I'm using the HDMI and Ethernet cables for that because it's convenient, but you can also see how the system compares in size to the Xbox 360. To perform a system transfer, both PlayStations have to be on the same network and running at least software version 4.0. Both of my systems are running 4.05, so I'm good to go. To find out your system software version, go to Settings, System, System Information. I have both PlayStations hooked up to my receiver so I can toggle between them, but you really only need the PlayStation 4 Pro on screen to perform the system transfer. Now I'll switch inputs and turn the PlayStation 4 Pro on for the first time. And check out that resolution. So I'm going to speed up this setup process because it takes a minute. Connect a controller to the system with a USB cable and hit the PlayStation button. And choose your language. Hit next. If you have a camera, set it up. Mine is still hooked up to the other PlayStation, so I'll do this later. So skip. Set your time zone. Set the time. Set your power options. Media playback is probably like Blu-rays or movies. General says applications, so maybe Netflix or games. But it'll automatically turn the system off after 4 hours or 1 hour, in my case, of inactivity, not moving the controller. When you're done with this, next. Here are more power options. So these are things that can remain on while it's in standby mode. So when you turn off the PlayStation, it's in like a suspended state. So you can leave the USB ports on, stay connected to the internet, it can auto-update and all that. Letting the PlayStation rest instead of completely turn off just kind of speeds up the booting process. Choose whatever you want and click Next. Accept the agreement if you want to use your PlayStation. And finally, hit Start Now. Choose User 1. Okay, software version 4.05 is ready to install. That matches the other PlayStation, so I'm going to install that now. Go to Notifications, go down to System Software and click it. And Next, and Update. Okay, hitting the PlayStation button and User 1. And now it wants me to sign into the PlayStation network. I'm going to do this in private, and I will be back. My information's saved. It's going to log me in. As a matter of fact, I do have another PlayStation 4 I want to transfer from. So, transfer data from another PS4. Check the following requirements before selecting Next. The other PS4 must be turned on, both PS4s must be connected to the same network with LAN cables, and that is the case. Press the power button of the source PS4 for 1 second until the system beeps to prepare to transfer data. It will take 66 minutes to transfer 460 gigabytes of my application's save data, captures, themes, and settings. Next. Do I want to deactivate my old PS4 as my primary PS4 and activate the new PS4 as my primary PS4? Yes. I want to activate this as my primary PS4. The name is lame, I know, I made it 10 years ago, and I can't change it. Thanks, Sony. Anyway. Next. Transferring will start. After transferring starts, the PS4 will not return to its current state. After you select Start Transfer, this PS4 will automatically restart, be initialized, and then data will be transferred to it. If you cancel while transferring, this PS4 will still be initialized. Start Transfer. Alright, the transfer process is complete, and it looks like it kept all my folders, so that's really cool. So the settings for 4K games or upscaled, whatever, any improvements that this system can provide, they're either already active when you start the game because it knows it's a PS4 Pro, or other games will have in-game display options. But that's it. That's how you do a system transfer. So thanks for watching.